Well, my middle name is Enoch, and that was my dad's name. Enoch Staley actually built the North Wilkesboro Speedway with partners in 1946. He's worked for NASCAR his whole life. He had an office in Daytona and an office in Talladega. And he died on May 22nd, 1995. And after he died, I was elected president of the track until it closed. Dad and John Maston and maybe Lawson Curry went to a race in Greenville, Pickens, or Greenville, South Carolina, and came back and thought it was a great idea. Let's build a racetrack. And so if somebody had some money and somebody had some equipment and somebody had the land, and that's how they partnered up. And then they built the track, and when they were grading the track, it was dirt till 1958. But when they're grading the track, they ran out of money, and that's why it's uphill in the backstretch and downhill in the front stretch.
Because they didn't finish grading it?
No, they ran out of money. They couldn't afford to pay anybody to do anymore.
How about that?
And they expected maybe 3,000 people at the first race, and they had 10,000.
They knew they were onto something.
I said, this is a pretty good idea. But they said, we didn't really have any plans after that first race because we didn't know. And then Bill France came up here and they got to be great friends, and Dad worked for NASCAR full time, traveled all over the country with Bill France. Dad was kind of like a troubleshooter for him. Dad was president of Ochinichi, which is Orange Speedway in Hillsboro, and he had Asheville Weaverville Speedway in Nashville.
Okay.
He was partners with the Hillsboro with Bill France. They were the only two owners of that track. It was a 9/10 mile dirt track.
Oh wow.
In Durham, or Hillsboro actually.
What have the last few months been like for you, knowing what's coming?
Oh, it's amazing. It's just great. I'm thinking if I'd had $20 million to play with, and what could I've done down there? You know, it'd been great. I'm glad. It's great.
Is it emotional?
A little bit, yeah, a little bit. I just, emotional in a good way, because it was hard for me to even go by there and see it deteriorate like it was. It's like pulling the Band-Aid off every time I went down there, and to see the buildings fall in and stuff like that. It's just, you'd rather see something new like that and see it deteriorate.
Are you going to the All-Star race?
I probably will. I don't know. We'll see.
Not sure?
If the owners invite me, I'll go.
What would your dad think of all this?
He'd be pretty amazed. He would like it, I'm sure.
What are some of your earliest memories of the track back when, back in its first iteration?
Oh gosh.
What was life like for you as a kid growing up so close to it, and Dad being the bigwig over there?
I remember probably the first time I ever went down there. I was probably 5 or 6 years ago. Old Mama took me down there and said, I want to go in the track, and there's guys at the gate, big old guys, I was afraid to go in. Mom said, tell who you are. I said, what? I was just shy, so I finally said, Enix, my daddy, I said, go home. So I was good then, But then later on, I grew up, and I enjoyed it. I enjoyed helping my dad and working around the track and did everything, park cars and, shovel ditches and run tractors and bush hog and whatever needed to be done. I helped him all I could.
Did you get to interact with the drivers much?
Yeah, quite a bit. I'd go down and talk to them. Marvin Panch was one of the best. He set me up on the pit wall one time and talked to me for a long time. He was a really nice guy. And Bobby Allison was a nice guy. I loaned him, as I got older, I had a Bonneville, a big Bonneville. Bobby flew in, I loaned him my car. Because he flew in his airplane, didn't have a car. And I loaned him, Dad said, loan him your car. I said, okay. I interacted with quite a few of the drivers and talked to them.
Very few people have had the experience and the link to a venue like that your family has. Everybody who lives in Wilkes County who's a racing fan,
I'm sure
was
impacted
negatively.
Yes.
Once it was no longer operational, and people may have been impacted by that on a personal level to different degrees. But I would have to imagine for you personally, it was exponentially worse.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was the best job I ever had in my life, working with my dad and then running the speedway, and it hurt everybody. I mean, it was terrible. And then the worst part was, they sold the speedway. But we didn't have much of a choice at the time, the way the times were changing. Because when the first half sold out, there's no way, I didn't have the money to go against anybody else that wanted to buy force us out, basically. So it was a hostile takeover, more or less.
Driving past it on 421 and seeing what it looked like, how hard was that for you?
Yeah, I didn't like to look at it. It was just deteriorated like that, and the buildings fell in, and you could see it. And it just, what was there at one time, how vibrant and alive, and the people that came, it's just amazing that it could go down that way.
Did you honestly ever think we'd get to where we are now?
No, not without the influx of a lot of money to come back, and luckily that's what happened.
You could argue it's one of the only good things to come out of COVID, couldn't you?
Yeah, that's true. That's true. It is, absolutely.
How involved are you, other than the family history and living so close? Are you involved at all with what's going on there right now?
Not right now, no. I'm not involved.
Because you guys have sold, and you're part of the history books at this point, right?
Yeah, more or less. Yeah.
Yeah.
More or less.
Yeah.
Well, it's just a great experience to be involved with what I'm involved with, and knowing the great people I know, and like Jody Kyle and the Kyle family. I mean, they were the backbone of the Speedway. The great people, the people you meet, and all my good memories. I mean, just look around. I mean, it's just great. There's a hat that they wore on the beach at Daytona. I found that, had thrown up, and I cleaned it up. That NASCAR hard hat.
How important is the hyper local community to making a track like North Wilkesboro run and be successful?
Oh yeah, we had great people working there, but back then, the one thing I like to make a point of is a lot of people took the track for granted back then. They've got a lot of good support now. People realize what they had and what they lost. The commissioners and the town commissioners and the mayors, they kind of just, took it for granted. Because I remember we had one county commissioner that she said, "I can't afford to go to the race. The tickets are too high." Our highest ticket was $60. And the politicians, the mayors, they didn't have to buy a ticket. We'd furnish them credentials. And, just little things like that. But now they've got people realize it, and there's a different group of people who's got so much support and helping and everything. I think it's great.
What happens after the All-Star race? I realize you don't necessarily have much say or influence anymore, but what would you like to see happen with that track? How should the community use it? How should NASCAR use it? I think everybody can agree we don't want to go back to the way it was, and they wouldn't have invested all this money for a one-off, right?
Absolutely. I think they could still have some great races there. One of my favorite races were the modifieds we ran on Saturday. They run those at Bowman Gray, and I think they could run there quite regularly, or have some. We used to have, after the cup races, we'd have two smaller events to kind of fill in the space between the two big races. Mm-hmm. And we'd have the late models and the modified and the street stocks and all those. I mean, it's a great place for those cars. It really is. They could do a lot with it. And like I say, they might have concerts there, musicals, whatever. Great facility.